Hey guys, it's Morgan and I'm back with another video. Excuse all this, it is like 1:30 in the morning, but I'm really, really excited to do this video. So I just wanted to jump on here and just kind of go for it. So like the title says, it is my 1 month ketoversary, or just not really a ketoversary because it's not been like over a year, but it's my 1 month marker. I've completed 4 weeks of keto. I've had some really good successes. I would say it's definitely a success overall, and I'm going to talk a little bit about those successes. Another thing is that, like the title says, I have 500 subscribers, and I am amazed because I never thought anyone would ever watch me or subscribe to me, and that is not as important as just the people who've like reached out to me, the advice I've gotten. People have reached out to me on Facebook. I've made some like cool friends, and I've gotten like so much support, and I never really knew how much doing Facebook would impact my weight loss journey. So I am super excited to be doing a giveaway. I personally love giveaways. Actually recently just won a giveaway, a book. It was my first one I ever won, so I kind of thought that was like, I've been thinking about doing a giveaway, and then I was like, oh my god, I won. So it's so exciting, and I love entering them, so I'm really excited to do this. I love giving, and I'm just really, really excited, and it's nice. Like, I'm super excited to show you guys what I got you, or one of you lucky people. So I'm really excited. So let me jump right into this video. So basically, like I said, I've had a lot of success. I don't know if a lot is really a good word, but I've had success on this keto way of eating, and it's been a full month. And so basically how I measure my success so far is three ways. One would be the scale, another would be measurements, and another one would be just like basic non-scale victories. And I kind of wrote myself like a couple of little notes over here on this cute Hello Kitty paper, so I wouldn't get kind of like off track, because this is one of those videos where some videos you don't need notes, you just kind of wing it, but this is one of those ones where notes actually could come in helpful. So I like organizing, so this just made sense to me to kind of organize it into three different parts, like scale, measurements, and non-scale. And I'll probably use that same kind of outline in the future when I'm doing like, you know, like my weekly or monthly reviews of my keto and my weight loss. So as you know, this whole channel was started because trying to lose weight. And if you've ever seen my earlier videos from like 2 years ago and on, there's a lot of failures. I've kind of like failed at this, tried again. And there's some failures in there, but I mean, I kept moving. I've never like ever accepted defeat or said like, this is impossible. I always just keep looking for something that'll work for me and try. So to me, that's a success in itself. So as far as the scale goes, this month I have lost 12 pounds. I started on February the 6th. So my 1 month marker was on March the 6th, and if you want to, you can go look on my Instagram. I always post pictures of my scale. I don't like really doing them videos because of the glare of the reflection, I should say. I don't like weighing myself with a ton of clothes on, so when I do it with my camera, for some reason, it just like, I can see myself in the reflection and I'm not wearing a lot of clothes, so it's just not gonna work out for me to do that. So I just take pictures of it and I post it onto my Insta just to kind of show my journey on there. So yeah, I'm down to 302. I did hit 302 before, like about like a week ago or so, but I kind of fluctuated to like 302, 304, 303, and I wasn't doing anything to gain. I wasn't eating anything to gain. It just was like fluctuating. It could have been water weight right there. I'm not really sure, but I did kind of for a second get slightly discouraged, but I just said to myself, you know, it's your first month. Your body is healing. And actually, I don't know if you guys ever heard of like doing a word of the year. So my word for 2017, I actually did a word of the year. When I do my office tour video, you'll see it. My word of the year, there's two. It's nourish and heal. Those are my words for the year. And I do a word of the year because it just helps me kind of like put all of my intention into that. That is my number one goal. Like, yes, I have other important things like work and family and stuff, but as far as like self-improvement and like extracurriculars, that is my goal, to nourish my body and heal it. So yeah, what was I getting at? Yeah, basically, like, I got a little bit discouraged when I only lost 12 pounds and I was kind of fluctuating, and I just don't, I'm like, really, my body's like resisting, and I really just want to get underneath that 300 mark so bad, but it's like really challenging for me anyways. So I'm just kind of being patient with my body. I'm not going to compare my results to another person. And I would have liked to lose more, but that's where I'm at. And 12 pounds is really decent for 1 month, and I'm cool with that. Measurements, I did measurements, and I will, I just did them like a few days back, I think in my last video. So I'll link that below here if you want to see my measurements. And I will do another measurement at the beginning of my second month. I'm probably going to do my measurements monthly and not weekly. So you can see my measurements in my last video. Like I said, I will link that video below. I'll just put measurements and put a link. I'm kind of glad that I didn't do my measurements right at the very, very beginning, because I think a lot of what I lost was my water weight and inflammation, and that will make your like ankles and your calves and your body, your neck, everything swell and kind of give you like a little bit of a false reading. I don't think it's bad to do the reading then and do the measurements, but for me, that's one of the things I've noticed, is just a lot of like debloating. So I'm kind of glad that I waited like a month and then took the measurements. And that way it's kind of like measuring fat loss more so than water weight, and I'm cool with that. So that's another way to measure my success. And the other way is my non-scale victories, and that's what I kind of want to talk about. I kind of hinted on it in the last video, but I really didn't have anything. Like, I had continually thought about things like, oh wow, this is great, this is because of what I'm doing on keto, but I didn't really write it down, and I didn't want to like sit there and try to think of everything off the top of my head. So yeah, I just kind of did write myself a couple of notes on this adorable Hello Kitty paper. So I'm just going to talk about some of my non-scale victories. And you know, these are things like, if I were selling the keto diet, these are things that, sorry about my itchy nose guys, every time I do a video my nose just itches, I don't know why. If I were like selling you on the keto diet, to me, these things are super important, because the weight loss is like good, but for someone like me who's heavy, like I'm 300 pounds, 302 pounds right now, losing 12 pounds, it's great, but it's kind of like, if you don't feel the change, then it's not going to be as like, it's not gonna be as attractive. Like if you don't see like results of some sort, even just like not weight loss, but there, you know, other things. So basically what I'm saying is that there's a lot of other things that has happened to me doing keto for just 1 month that I think is kind of miraculous and amazing to me. And all of that to me is just showing me that I'm on the right track, and it makes me want to stick with it, and it makes me just confident that it's working for me and for my body. Now, I do not subscribe to the belief that every single body does well on keto. I don't believe that. Yeah, well, maybe that's not the right way to word it. Do I think everybody can do keto? Probably, yeah. Do I think everybody needs to do keto? No. I don't think keto is for every single person, and the reason I say that, I think keto is kind of a little bit extreme. It's taking kind of like it's a little drastic or extreme, and I mean, this is just my opinion. I know there's some people on here who, or not really on here, like this is my channel so I can express my opinion, but being in forums on Facebook where people are on keto and watching YouTube videos, I see people who are like 15, 20 pounds overweight, and they have a wedding coming up, and so they want to lose that really, really like stubborn last 12, 15, 20, 25 pounds. So I can see why that would work for them, because it's kind of like one of those like it's gonna like reboot their body and like burn that fat and like give them different results than they were getting on a different way of eating. For me personally, I think keto is a little bit extreme. You're cutting out all carbs. But the thing is that my, sorry for saying so much, guys. My condition, my current state of health is it's an extreme situation. So it requires an extreme solution. And that's why I'm okay with the extremes of keto. Sorry for saying too much. So I'm not that great at making videos, but whatever. Okay, so let's just get right into the different non-scale victories. So what I will say, just to kind of preface this whole thing, is when I was, before I hit 30, when I was in my 20s, 28, 29, 27, 30, 31, even 32 years old, I was untouchable. I didn't have a single ache or pain. I didn't have any difficulty sleeping. I never got up in the middle of the night to go pee. I never had a heartburn in my life. I think I had heartburn one time in elementary school because I drank a whole thing of like ramen broth, or I think it was chicken noodle soup broth, like a huge pot of it. And I got my first heartburn. I thought I was having a heart attack, but I never had heartburn as an adult. I never was extremely winded. I never had any issues with energy. I never had any medical things come up. Every time I went to the doctors, as chubby or as, you know, big as I was getting, I had good blood pressure, good cholesterol, and everything was totally fine. And I think it was just kind of sheer luck. Another thing that I think helped it was I was a really active, chubby person. I've always had good energy. When I was in high school, I played sports, and I've usually been pretty active. I've always walked a lot, and I was pretty social, and I did a lot of stuff when I was like in my 20s. Like, I wasn't like home all the time. I was doing stuff, and I always have had pretty decent energy. So all of that changed for me around 32, and what happened was is I started feeling the effects of my weight, and I always told myself that it would catch up with me and this is unhealthy. But the thing is that, you know, I don't know if it was just that I was just so caught up in my like own imagination, my own mind, and I was just busy living life, and I just was like I was okay with it for some reason. I don't know why. I don't know if it was because I didn't care about myself enough, or I don't know if it was because I just was too lazy. I don't know exactly what it was, but for some reason there was this like mind-body disconnect for some reason, and I just wasn't motivated enough to like really take care of my body extra, because in a way I felt attractive and I felt like I was comfortable in that. I was comfortable in that fatness, and I kind of liked the attention I got from it. I don't know if anybody has ever experienced this, but if you're a cute 22, 23 year old girl and you're like a little bit chubby and your boobs are big and like you're kind of curvy, you're not just another pretty skinny girl. You're like kind of like this almost like it was an exotic kind of feeling. Like, I kind of felt like a little bit like, I don't know if I would say fetishy, that I was a fetish, but I don't know what the word is. I just felt kind of like different. I felt like it made me stood out. I also felt like it made me a little bit more intimidating, because I'm like not intimidating at all internally, but it made me feel a little bit more like I liked the feeling of taking up more space, and I didn't mind because I felt like my body was nice. I felt like, you know. So fast forward to 32, and I'm just a warning for all of you young 20 year olds, like, it will catch up with you, and it will be harder and harder to maintain that. You know, you start getting little effects, like I got these little stretch marks on my shoulders, and you just start aging like kind of slowly, and it just kind of catches up with you. And so one of the physical things that started happening to me was swelling. So I never experienced swelling or bloating. I might have kind of bloated at certain times, but I never had like water retention that I noticed. I think my sister, who's younger than me, started experiencing water retention. She's like 3 years younger than me before I did, because she would come on vacation and she would be complaining like, oh, I'm so swollen from the plane ride. And I'm just like, I've never experienced like swelling. But what happened was around 32 and a half, right there somewhere, I started experiencing swelling where I would noticeably look down at my feet and be like, whoa, my feet were like, it was like, at first I didn't really know what was going on. And then like my feet were like so like spread, and like my, I don't know, you know what I'm saying. If you are watching this, you probably know what I'm saying. So that started happening and it wasn't cute. I just didn't like it. It wasn't like I had like some massive like lymphedema or anything like that, but it just was not cute. And it would happen at first, like if I ate really, I noticed like a pattern. If I ate really shitty, I would get more swole, and then I would like unswell. I don't know what the word is, but I would pee all night long, like pee all night long. And I started getting up to go pee a lot, like even if I wasn't like super swollen. And then it got to a point where I couldn't even tell if I was really swollen, you know? Like that's kind of like a more recent thing here, like 36. Like I would go weeks and weeks and weeks and not even really notice I was swollen. And then all of a sudden I would like pee all throughout the night, and I would wake up the next day and my feet would be extremely slim. And I would say, wow, like swollen is the new normal. And I was like, that was a huge kind of alarm. Another thing is the heartburn thing I talked about. When I was younger, I could literally eat anything and never feel any kind of pain, discomfort, or there was no kind of consequence to my eating. I could literally, in my 20s, sit down and just eat a whole pizza if I wanted to. I could eat the most disgusting thing. I literally would call my stomach, and this is gonna sound kind of gross. I don't know if you've ever heard of this boat. It's in Boston or New England somewhere called Old Ironsides. It was kind of like unsinkable or untouchable. I swear, my stomach, I would call it like Old Ironsides. Like I didn't eat a lot of disgusting things, but I could handle anything and I would never get sick. Like other people be like, oh my God, like I'm getting food poisoning. I'm like, I don't feel it. Like my body just like digested it. And I never had any kind of like side effects whatsoever. And then what started happening is I started getting a lot of consequences to what I was eating, and it started, like I said, right around 32. So I would eat specifically anything with sauce, like spaghetti or pizza, and I would get heartburn. And I'm talking about super heartburn. And maybe it's not as super as other people's, but to me, never having it, I felt like I was just like dying of a heart attack. And it got excessively bad in Disney World. That was last, not this 2016, 2015 Christmas. It was so bad. I woke up in the middle of the night and my throat was on fire. I don't know if it was kind of like a reflux or what it was, but I had to send my husband to the CVS in the middle of the night, and I had to like just, you know. So what happened was I would avoid eating certain things. But eventually, even a little bit of something that I considered not that bad for me, it would just start, I would have heartburn. So I would have Tums by my bed, and I would kind of sometimes foresee it coming. And to me, that was just unacceptable. And this is a relatively new kind of situation. It hasn't been a long-term thing, but to me, it was unacceptable. Alarms were going off in my head, like, this is not okay. Both of these two things to me were warning signs. They were both warning signs of my health deteriorating, and I needed to do something about it. And I had kind of like procrastinated my whole life with, okay, I can get away with my weight. Okay, cool, there's no consequences. Bam. As soon as I started seeing consequences, I am not waiting around till I get diabetes. Like, I am determined to do something about it. And these consequences, these real life like things, wake me up. Another thing that kind of I feel like my eating was affecting was, well, actually, before I even go into there, let me also just say, sometimes there wasn't, this goes with the heartburn thing, I just kind of want to add this in there. Sometimes it wasn't heartburn, but sometimes it was just discomfort. I'm not talking about I ate so much I was stuffed. I'm talking about it got to a point where if I ate pizza, I was uncomfortable. I would be in pain. Like, my stomach just hurt. Like, I don't know if it was my stomach or my intestines, but I was just in pain. Like, I just felt like it was just too much. Like, I started getting to a point where I rarely could handle it. I didn't like it. And I didn't want it. And then when I did have pizza, because I just wanted a piece, I would literally limit myself to like two small little pieces or like one piece, because I just couldn't tolerate the pizza. So on to the next thing, which I'm going to talk about, which is mood. So one thing that I think was really, really starting to become affected, like recently at 36, 35, was my mood. I would sometimes catch myself being irritable, and I didn't like myself when I did that. Like, I mean, it's okay to be irritated sometimes, like everybody gets that, but I would catch myself being snappy, moody, and hangry. Like, especially if I was hungry, like I would just get that. I would get anxiety, like not like extreme anxiety, but just this like anxious feeling, like, and I would get moody, irritable, and I felt a lot of like mood fluctuations that I never felt before. And at one point, I think I started like questioning if maybe I needed to like go see somebody, because I was just feeling not quite like myself. And I was like, what is going on? Like, is there a possibility that I could be getting depression? Like, I would watch, I'm not laughing because depression is a joke, it's not, but I would watch commercials, and I would say, oh my god, I have that, you know, like depression commercials, like Latuda. And so I did a lot of research, and I do think there's like definitely, like, not even into my opinion, but like scientifically, a connection between your mood and your food. And I think what really kind of like opened my eyes was like I met this person, and she was like so moody, and like she would just like snap, and like she was just very like out of control, like with her snapping. And I was like, wow, like. And she had other symptoms to me too that were kind of like signs of obesity, and I was like, no, I just can't deal. Like, I don't know if this is making any sense. I hope I'm making a little bit of sense, because I'm just like conversating, and I don't, even though I know what I'm saying to myself, like I get what I'm saying, it's sometimes I don't think my communication is the best, and I am working on that. So I hope that makes sense. So the other thing is energy. Well, actually, let me just say this. So I've talked about swelling, heartburn, and mood. My swelling has completely gone down. I am not swollen. And I don't think that's 100% the case. I think that 80% or 85% of my swelling, water retention, is gone. I don't know if, because I'm overweight, my body is still going to retain a little bit more water than a healthy weight person. But I'm just assuming that. And the reason I think that is because, like, sometimes in my calf, it feels a little bit kind of like, a little bit. Like, I don't have like massively swollen legs. I just mean it's kind of slight, but I still kind of like feel like there's like a little bit of like water retention in there. So that's what I think. But for the most part, my swelling has drastically decreased, almost to like nothing. Like I said, there's probably some water retention, but for the most part, it's completely gone. My feet never have that, like, I can see like the kind of like the bone or the lines on the top of my feet, and I can like bend my foot, and there's not this little like fat bubble roll kind of thing on my ankle. It's just kind of like more slim on my ankles. And yeah, so my swelling is gone, and it has not returned. I haven't been excessively like swelling and like peeing a lot. It's not happening. My swelling has just been reduced drastically, and I'm super happy about that. I see that as like a health indicator that my health is going in the right direction. my heartburns, I have not had one single heartburn. And I eat pepperoni and I eat burgers. I eat cheeseburgers off the grill. I eat chicken off the grill, like drumsticks off the grill. I eat wings with hot sauce. I eat reduced sugar ketchup. And I have not had one single even inkling of a heartburn. Not one. Not even a little bit of that like warning sign after you eat at night when you're just sitting around and you're like, oh yeah, I'm gonna get a heartburn in the middle of the night. When I get my heartburns, they hit at like 2, 3, 4, or 5 in the morning after I sleep for a little bit and have to like take a shit ton of Tums and like lay on one side and drink 9 gallons of water. It totally disrupts my sleep. So I haven't had a single solitary heartburn, no reflux, whatever that was, gone. And mood, I have not been moody at all. Like, I'm very stable. I don't have like those hunger, hangry feelings like, oh my God, I need to eat for kill somebody. Oh my God. Like, I don't get that at all. Like, my appetite is another thing. It has been really regulated. There are times when I wake up and I am not hungry all day long. And it's so much more comfortable for me. I was sitting in my chair just the other day and I was like, and this may sound a little crazy to some people, but I said to myself, this must be how normal people feel about food. I wasn't sitting there, I wasn't thinking about food, I wasn't thinking about what was coming in my next meal, I wasn't obsessing over food in any way, shape, or form, I wasn't wondering what I was going to eat for dinner, I wasn't wondering what I was going to eat for the week, I wasn't having any kind of feelings about food, I wasn't having any like, this sounds good, I wasn't watching food commercials thinking, oh my God, I wish I could eat that, I wasn't thinking about cheesecake or anything like that at all, and I literally had a lot of moments just even throughout last week where I was like, this is what normal people feel like about food every day. And if I had this, what's the word I'm looking for? It starts with a D. Oh my gosh. Not disinterest, but you know, when you're not against it or for it, you're just in the middle. Do you know what I'm saying? What's that word? Oh God, what's that word? I forget, you guys, my vocabulary. But if I had this kind of like, mediocre, kind of like in the middle, like not, oh my God, I need that word, that's exactly the word I need and I can't think of it, but if I just had that neutral tone about food, it wasn't nothing but it wasn't something, it was just food, my life, I would never have been obese. Like, I would never have had the urge to eat. Like, I would have satiety. Like, I've had satiety like I've never had in my life. Like, I've just not had any kind of food. Some of you might not understand what I'm talking about, but if you're chubby, fat, obese, or have any issues with your weight, you may or may not understand what I'm saying, and I'm hoping some of you do, and I'm hoping I'm getting through to somebody, and hopefully, you know, there's somebody there who can understand what I'm saying and feel me on this level. My energy is the next thing. I'm not gonna lie, one thing that I was a real eye-opener, even beyond the swelling and the heartburn and the mood, was my energy level was definitely depleted. Not gonna lie, guys, like when I was at my very heaviest, which was 333 pounds, now I'm 302, but I've only lost 12 of these pounds on keto. The other ones I gradually took off just from calming down on the food. When I was at my heaviest, I was like really feeling drained, and I would say to myself, this must be what being old feels like, this must be what dying feels like. Like, I was like sapped, I was like, like I just had no get up and go. And sometimes mentally I still had that desire to get up and go, so I would like wake up and get dressed and like start some laundry and be all ready to go shopping or whatever. And I would just be like, oh my God, I can't do it. I cannot do it. Some days I would like go to Walmart and go shopping just for household stuff or groceries. By the time I got back, I was drained. I was just done. I was just like, and some days I got up and I just couldn't even manage. Like, I couldn't even function. And luckily, like, I work for myself, so I had that ability to say, like, the luxury of saying, I'm not doing nothing today. I'm doing nothing. Like, I just cannot. Like, I just need to, like, just... I just didn't have the energy. And one thing I can say is that my energy has drastically improved. Now, do I think I'm at 100%? No. I know what my energy level can be, but I'm definitely way up there. Like, I'm definitely at 75% of my energy potential for my age. Like, I feel my energy coming back. I'm a lot more active. I do more stuff. There's more spring in my step, and I don't feel tired and drained, and I feel so good. Another thing I want to talk about, and I don't really know what the word for this is. I guess it's just kind of like physically how I feel, or maybe it kind of goes in the category of stamina. I feel lighter. I've only lost 12 pounds. I can feel it. And one of the ways I know for sure is because me and my husband went to a movie tonight. We went to go see Logan. It's really good, by the way. And I specifically recall the last couple times we've gone to movies, maybe not the last movie, but a couple before that, like in January, December, I remember walking up the stairs to the movie theater. You know how like you walk into the theater itself and there's the stairs up to your seat? I was breathing hard walking up those stairs, hard. To the point where I was a little bit embarrassed, even it was just my husband who could probably hear me, but I was like, holy shit, I have gotten so fat. I was like, holy crap, I could hear myself breathing hella hard. And I was like, oh my God, this is just like, all these signs were just pointing at my like horrible health. And I will say today, when I went up the stairs to the theater, I was not breathing hard at all. And another thing I will say is, as I was climbing the stairs, I felt that boost to run. Like, I felt that natural kind of like momentum spring. Like, it was such a good feeling, and I recognized it. And I was like, there's Morgan. Like, I haven't seen that in a minute. Like, that kind of like, like, I just felt like I was just kind of upstairs, and I just kind of felt that bounciness. Oh, that's so good. And so these little things really make me want to keep losing and keep going, because I want to feel good, and I don't want to like age gracefully and just stay fat and just be like, yeah, like, I just don't buy into that whole school of thinking. And that kind of goes into like a whole nother conversation. But I'm definitely fighting for my health, and I'm definitely one of those people, like, I just never really accepted being fat, even at 300 pounds. I was like, this is gonna stop, like, and it's just really gotten really serious and to a critical point. Like, no, I don't have high cholesterol or high blood pressure at this point, but, and I don't have diabetes, nothing, like, serious, but I'm not trying to get to that point before I smarten up. I need to smarten up, and that's basically what I'm doing, okay, guys? So this video is getting super long, guys. So just one more thing to talk about before I do the giveaway, and this has to do with the giveaway. So I actually do want to talk about some things, but I think I'm going to do it on a separate video. And what I want to talk about is what I've been doing on keto that's been working for me, what I've been doing on keto that's definitely not working for me. And I want to talk about like the commitments that I made at the beginning of the month in February and what I've been doing this whole entire month. And I want to talk about the new commitments that I'm going to make for my March month. And one thing that I am going to talk about in this video, the other ones I will save. I want to do a February review, and that's what I'm going to save for that video, so this is not extremely long. But one thing that I am going to talk about that has been working for me is YouTube. So I have 500 subscribers, which is, to me, that's crazy. I know I keep saying that, but that's absolutely crazy, and I'm absolutely like, what? What? Like, that's crazy. Like, people reach out to me on Facebook. I honestly, you guys, I live out here in the middle of Georgia nowhere, about 45 minutes outside of Atlanta. I have no friends out here. I had one friend. It was a horror story, and I might do a story time about that. But this YouTube experience has been really, really great. Number one, the most obvious thing that is right there is accountability. But accountability is such like a vague word. It kind of, you know, just like, yeah, I'm gonna say and commit to doing something and then I'm gonna have to stick to it. But it's so much more than that. And one of the things is community. So people have reached out to me on Facebook, Instagram. They have, you know, just given me support and shown me like positivity, compliments, like way to go, like you're doing a good job. When I say something on my videos, like I don't know if I'm doing the right thing, or I get people who say like, I had that same thing happen to me, try this. I've had people say, don't beat yourself up, keep going, stay positive, just really, really encouraging words. Another thing is I have people who reach out on Facebook who are like friends, who they just want to talk about their experience and chat and encourage each other. And I so appreciate that, because I never really understood how important support was. And the thing is that even if you have no friends, even if you are super shy, even if you are whatever, even if you live in the most remote area, you can find a community and find support and find people who are on a similar journey to you, and there's just so much positivity. It's crazy. And a lot of times, like even your family members or friends, they don't really get your weight loss goals. They don't really understand what you're going through. Even your spouse. I mean, me and my husband are on the same journey. He's losing weight like crazy on keto. He's losing like a pound a day. I'm a woman. It's totally different. So the support is out there. People are caring. People are supportive. I've gotten no negativity at all, like except for like 2 years ago, my first video, I got a little bit of negativity, but whatever. Also, YouTube introduced me to like some Facebook keto groups, and those have been super, super helpful. Like with, you know, on Facebook, it's more like chats and information, whereas like Facebook, it's information, but it's like a whole different like delivery system. So like recipes, like right now, if you told me like make a meal plan, I don't know what I'd make. I have to see stuff and visually see it and say, okay, I want to make that. And like, that's how I develop my meal plan. And if it wasn't for this community, like I would never know what to make. I would be so bored. Even looking at Pinterest, like I get way better ideas on Facebook and YouTube. So another thing too is I get a lot of people who say things like, oh, I really wanted to do YouTube, but I didn't dare to because I have some limitations. I have other people say like, oh, you're so brave that you do this. Like, I want to do it, but I'm scared. Just do it. This is for you. Like, nobody even has to watch this crap. Like, everything coming out of my mouth is basically my opinion. Like, it's more for me to get it out. And like, if you've even considered doing YouTube, just do it. Like, just get on there. I mean, I honestly don't even like advertise my YouTube on my Facebook. Like, I don't really know if I want my family and friends to really see this. This is just my personal journey. So, yeah. So just get out there and do it. And doing YouTube makes my journey so much more real. Like, it makes it an actual weight loss journey. It doesn't make it a task anymore. It doesn't make weight loss like this burden. It makes it something so much more enjoyable to me and so much more like I look forward to it. And just today I was like doing some stuff in the basement getting ready to go out on date night, and I was like, wow, like, do you know what YouTube has done for my weight loss journey? It has turned it into an actual enjoyable journey where I can enjoy the moment. I'm so much more aware of what I'm doing in the moment, and I'm enjoying the moment, that I'm not worried about this sucks, I can't wait till it's over, I can't wait to get to my goal. Like, literally, when you do this, for me, this whole YouTube experience just over this month alone, it is just really, really made it so much more enjoyable as a journey. And I stay in that moment, in that headspace, and I'm so much more aware of my changes, and I'm constantly thinking, and it just really, really does something for me. And I noticed some people doing a YouTube channel would be like a lot of work and a complete waste of time for them and like stressful. And if it is those things to you, that's totally understandable. Don't do it if it's like hard and it makes your weight loss journey harder. But for me, it's doing wonders for me. Like, it's keeping me so much on track, and I really, really love it. And I thank you guys so much for watching me and the support you've given me and all the love, because there's so many haters and there's so much cattiness in the world, but I so appreciate it. And so it gets me to the giveaway, guys, and I'm super excited because, oh goodness, let me just say, like, I really tried to think about what I was gonna do for the giveaway. I thought about everything. One of the ideas I had, and let me know if you think I should do this for a future giveaway or maybe just like a fun giveaway thrown in there somewhere, because God knows I love to shop and I love to give away stuff. So I thought about doing a keto weight loss kit, or a keto kit, and I was gonna actually get like a bathroom scale, a food scale, some keto sweetener, and a couple other fun things that you would need to start keto. But I didn't want to do that because everybody who watches me is not doing keto. They might not really want artificial sweeteners, or, you know, they're not artificial, but they're like, you know, keto alternative sweeteners. I don't know. Not everybody wants to eat those. So I really, really thought about it and thought about it and thought about it. And I wanted something that would be universally usable, lovable, awesome. So, okay, guys, here's the big reveal. It's really nice and I hope you guys love it. Here it is. So this is not sponsored, guys. I bought this with my own money because I love you. And I actually, I considered getting a more gender appropriate band that you could, you know, a boy or a girl could wear. But I got this one because it's so darn cute. It is lavender with rose gold accents, and I absolutely think it's darling. I just couldn't pass it. And now that I got it, and like the packaging is so nice, and like it literally, the kind of looks like the rose gold on the front actually like glimmers, and I'm just really seeing how beautiful it is. And so yes, now I might actually go ahead and get myself one of these also. So if you win this, let me know how it works. I actually have my own Fitbit. It's the Fitbit Ulta. And it's actually going to be one of my commitments to wear this more often, because as I get into 300s, I'm going to start my workout journey. Right now, I'm just on my weight loss journey as far as my diet goes. I haven't even started my workout journey, and I cannot wait to be a beast in the gym. So yeah, back to this. I don't really know what to say. It's all right here. I will link it if you want to look it up and check it out on Amazon. That's where I bought it. Like I said, I purchased it myself off Amazon. And yeah, it's just the Fitbit Charge 2. I think they kind of like snagged this look, the coloring, from the Apple Watch, because Apple Watch actually has a lavender with rose gold. So I think, and that one was way before this color scheme, but this is limited. So I'm gonna have to buy me one right away. And I'm just kind of like, I don't know if I really need one, because I hardly use this one. So I don't know if I really need one, but it's absolutely adorable. And I got it in a size large, right here. You put your wrist to kind of see, and I got a large because I assume that like people who are watching me might be on a weight loss journey and might want a large. But the thing is that whether or not you're a guy or a girl, you can get this and you can change up the band. So if you are a small wrist, you do not have to be in a weight loss journey to want to get this, or you don't have to be a big person to win this. So basically, so here are some basic rules, and I'm going to put these in the description. Number one, it's not going to be international. It's going to be just national, just the USA. You can be in Alaska or Hawaii. I'm totally cool with that. And I'm just making up these things right like I thought about them. But yeah, the only reason I'm doing that, nothing against international, I just don't think I can afford postage, because I think it'll probably be pretty expensive if it's going somewhere cray. So I probably, yeah, just let's do US and Canada. So if you're in Canada, I'm pretty sure I can send it to you. So US and Canada is fine. And, all I really want you to do, you have to be 18 or older. If you're a child, ask your parents' permission. Cause I don't want to, you know, send some kid a watch and some, you know, expensive merchandise. And all I want you to do is just subscribe to my page. If you have Instagram, please follow me on Instagram. If you have Facebook, follow me on Facebook. And just because I'd like to see your journey too, and we can be cool, be friends, whatever. I just think that'd be cool to see your life, because this is kind of intimate. You get to see my life, and I'm totally open, so that would be kind of cool. If you don't have Facebook or you don't feel comfortable giving out Facebook to people who aren't your family or friends, totally understood. You don't have to do that. But what I want you guys to do is I want you to tell me in 5 words or less why you want this Fitbit and how it will change or affect your life in 5 words or less. That's it. Just 5 words or less. Just a quick little thing. And it can be like why you want it or how it will affect or change your life, your journey, or just your life. You don't have to be on a weight loss journey to win it. So that's what I want. You do not have to do the comment on here. You can do it here. You can do it on Facebook, or you can do it on Instagram, because I'm actually going to advertise the giveaway on my Insta and on my Facebook. So if you want to, you can do a comment on all 3, or if you want to, you can do a comment on here. And I think what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to have my husband pick the winner, just to kind of be fair. I'm also going to consult and see how do people pick winners. I don't know. So I will be sending it directly to you from me. So you will have to be able to provide me with your address when you're the winner. And I will keep this giveaway going until probably my next weigh-in next Monday, or yeah, it'll probably be Monday. So I will post the winner next Monday, which I don't have the date right in front of me. But today is the 7th, so I will post it, I think it'll be the 14th of March. The Ides of March, yes. So I will post the winner then, and I will post it I probably will go into the description, put who the winner is, and say that the giveaway is closed. And I'll also post the winner on my Instagram and Facebook. So you can find it there. I will tag you and let you know. So yeah, good luck, guys. I hope you really like it. It actually was $179 on Amazon because it's the color. It's just such a beautiful color. I couldn't resist it. It was well worth the extra like $20, $30 for this color because it's stunning and I love it. And it's like, it's jewelry. It's gorgeous. And I might have to get me one. So yeah. So I'm going to end the video here, and thanks so much for watching. I hope there was something on here that could help you out. And if you want to, go ahead and subscribe. No pressure. And I love you guys, and have a good one. Bye.